गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट, वी आर लर्निंग
प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस।
इन दिस क्लास वी विल
लर्न द डिफरेंट यूजेस ऑफ प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस।
डियर स्टूडेंट, दिस टेंस इज यूज्ड टू मेंशन डिफरेंट यूनिवर्सल सिंगुलर। डियर स्टूडेंट, इट्स यूजेज इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन। डियर स्टूडेंट, लेट्स लर्न
to mention different universal general truth.
Dear student, you have to recognize it when the exam comes, given in your exams.
The sun rises in the east.
Dear student,
sun rises.
First form,
with,
as or es, is used.
So, the sun rises in the east.
Dear student, this is a universal truth. You know, sun rises in the east. It is true here and in abroad, in anywhere.
So, universal truth.
In universal truth,
simple present tense or present indefinite tense is used.
Present indefinite tense means first form of the verb.
If the subject is singular, we add s or
es to the first form of the verb.
Here the sun is singular subject. So first form has
s or es.
Water boils at 100 degree centigrade.
Dear student, this is a scientific fact and it is true, general truth, here and anywhere.
So,
to express scientific fact, we use
present indefinite tense. Dear student, the earth moves around the sun. The earth moves around the sun.
This is a universal truth.
So, the earth
is singular subject.
Move,
verb
with s. The stars shine at night. Dear student, this is
universal truth.
In universal truth, we use present indefinite tense.
Verb की first form of the verb is simple present tense.
So,
तो dear students,
to mention
different universal and general truth and scientific fact,
we use simple or present indefinite tense.
Present indefinite tense means first form of the verb. If subject is singular, we will use singular verb. We add s or es with to the first form of the verb. If the subject is plural, we use only first form of the verb.
Second rule, to make statement of general nature.
Dear student,
we hear, some example, we hear with our ears.
Dear student,
hear some perception verbs. Hear, smell,
you know,
these are those verbs that is not used in ing form. We hear with our ears. The rose smells sweet. Rule number third, to express a habitual actions
in present time.
Dear student, we will use present indefinite tense.
Habitual action in present time,
we will use present indefinite tense.
What is present indefinite tense? First form of the verb.
He often comes late.
Dear student,
comes.
subject is singular, so first form of the verb is as.
Hari never goes office late.
Dear student, in this sentence, a habitual action is expressed, which occurred regularly after some time. Dear student,
rule number 3, in newspaper headline, we use present indefinite tense.
Dear student, only headlines, we will use
present indefinite tense.
Two murderers escape. This event has past. This event is related to past, but in newspaper headline, we use
present indefinite tense.
Here, present indefinite tense is used, first form of the
verb. Two murderers
escape.
Dear student, rule number 4, to narrate different actions at the time of speaking, or we can say with running
commentary,
present indefinite tense is used.
Dear student, you will have to memorize it. The newspaper headlines, which tense is used?
To narrate different action at the time of speaking, which tense is used?
With running commentary, which tense will be used?
So, dear student, you have to recognize when this two murderers ask what is the sense.
This is newspaper headlines, so we will use
present indefinite to narrate different action at the time of speaking with running commentaries. When the door opens, many people enter the room. Dear student, here two clauses. First, when the door opens, in this clause the present indefinite tense is used, opens, and the action is being when the speaker is speaking. When the door opens, jab the door opens, many people enters. So in other clause we will use present indefinite tense.
Sehwag hits the ball over mid-wicket boundary and Harry fills the ball and throws it to the wicket keeper. So, it is a running commentary which is continued when the speaker speaks.
Rule number 5, to refer historic events. India defeats Pakistan in cricket. Now Akbar calls Birbal and asks.
Yes, student, other example, Maharana Pratap fights like a lion.
Dear student, rule number 6, to describe a pre-planned travel plan
of near future,
which based on certain
schedule.
Dear student, we leave for Jaipur at a.m. and reach there at 9. Dear student,
other example, Aishwarya Rai comes here tomorrow and leaves for Kota at noon.
Dear student, some examples are given here. The Chetak Express leaves for Delhi at 4:30 a.m. His father retired next Monday. My mother, my wife and I are returning from abroad to India next week. Dear student, rule number 6 is to mention a fixed program with timetable. Classes begin next Monday.
Dear student, we will have to something in our mind when we use present indefinite tense with fixed future planned actions.
डियर स्टूडेंट प्री प्लान ट्रेवल प्लान ऑन नियर फ्यूचर बेस्ड ऑन सर्टेन शेड्यूल एंड टू मेंशन फिक्स्ड प्रोग्राम विद टाइम टेबल. Here some examples, the Chennai Express leaves for Delhi at 4:30 a.m. is a fixed program in near future. To express this present indefinite tense is used. Dear student, when the speaker is involved with action, we will use present continuous in near future. And when the officer or speaker is not involved in action, we will use simple present tense or present indefinite tense. Here we can see his father retires next month. Dear student, here in this example, his father retires next Monday. You can see his father retires next Monday. Pre-planned in near future. But in this sentence, present indefinite tense is used, not present continuous tense. Yani, present simple tense and present continuous tense are used to express in near future. Future planned action or fixed plan action. The speaker is not involved in this action. His father retires. Speaker is not involved. In this sentence, my mother, my wife and I are returning from abroad to India next week. In this sentence, my mother, my wife and I, speaker, is involved in action. So, we will use present continuous tense to express future plan X. Dear student, roll number 7, to show future time using when or in conditional sentences. First example, I shall do it when he comes. Dear student, this here two clauses are given. First one, I shall do it. Here future indefinite tense. And when he comes, subordinate clause, when clause will be in simple present tense or present indefinite tense. If when clause is in present indefinite tense, the principal clause will be future simple tense. Here some example, when I finish the letter. In this sentence, when clause is in present indefinite tense, so principal clause is in future indefinite tense. I will give it to you. Conditional sentence, if she sees Kamal, she will tell. Here, dear student, conditional clause is in present indefinite tense, and here future indefinite tense. So you will have to recognize that principal clause is in future indefinite tense. We will have to fill with present indefinite tense. To begin imperative sentences, we use first form, which is present indefinite tense with proverb idioms, time and tide get found on. This is a proverb. Slow and steady wins the race. This is a proverb. To express proverb idioms, present tense, present indefinite tense is used. Dear student, in your examination, how will you identify which tense, what tense is used here? Some adverb of time is given here. They are always, when, if,
इन ए सेंटेंस ऑलवेज इज यूज इट मीन्स नॉर्मली जनरली इट इज प्रेजेंट इंडिपेंडेंट टेंस इट शोज प्रेजेंट इंडिपेंडेंट टेंस
ऑलवेज ऑफन समटाइम्स यूजुअली जनरली ओकेजनली सेल्डम रेयरली रेगुलरली डेली
ओकेजनली दीज एडवर्ब ऑफ टाइम शोज प्रेजेंट इंडिपेंडेंट टेंस
एवरी डे Every night, every month, every year,
shows present indefinite tense.
Each day, each night, each month, every year.
If
yesterday, each day
is used in a sentence, we will feel present indefinite
tense. On Sundays,
on Mondays,
this tense
is used.
In the morning,
in the evening, we will use present indefinite tense.
Once, twice in a week, twice in a day,
shows present indefinite tense.
You write many stories daily. Here, adverb of time daily shows present indefinite tense. Yesterday, many books are written on India
every month.
Every month shows
present indefinite
tense. So. Here, present indefinite tense is used, but you can see here, you will see here, present indefinite tense is given, but in passive form.
Thank you.